Okay, so this is what's going on here. I don't have a hose. I actually don't have a hose to run into my van, so this is where you put the water in right here. Whoops. Swirling around. This is where you put the water in. Just pull this plug out, kind of. Doesn't seem to come out very easily. It's coming. There we go. So I made a little gadget here with some PEX I had in the funnel. Well, hello everybody. Well, there I am. I'm filling my RV with a 1 gallon container. And I had to go in and out of the house 18 times to fill it. I don't have a hose, so you'd be better off if you had a hose. Anyways, this is a continuing fun with the 2018 Erwin Hymer Group Sunlight V2 or Van 2. And I've had this thing now for a couple of months. And this, I actually shot this video about a week ago because we finally had temperatures that were actually warmer than freezing. So I could finally put some water in and see how the tanks work, the water pump works, and emptying out the holding tanks works. And there I go now, off to the house to get another gallon of water. Oh boy. So anyways, the fill is right there on the door jamb, the driver's door jamb, which I showed you at the very beginning. And there is 17.6 gallons of fresh water is what you is the capacity. And in addition to that 17.6 gallons, there's also a 6 gallon hot water tank. So in reality, you have about 23 and a half gallons of fresh water that you can carry around. Okay, I'm back. I really want to top this tank off again. So that was a gallon. I didn't think I ran a gallon out yesterday, but okay, so, oh man. Oh shit. It's all over my pants. Okay, well, if you notice the water was coming out of the side of the door, that's how you know that tank is full. I didn't mention that, but I just did. Now, right here, I'm beginning to fool around with the what they call the city water supply. And this is where if you pulled into a campground, you'd connect one end of your hose to the water supply at the campground, and you would put the other end into this little nozzle right here. And you would not be using your water pump. You would be using the water pressure from the campground. But the reason why I'm really showing this is I'm going to slide in underneath here. There we go, right? Oh, there we go. And you see that spigot right there? And it's right there, that spigot. That right there, when I filled my water, that was turned on and all the water came spilling out. So make sure that spigot is turned off before you fill your water. There it goes onto my GoPro. Okay, so I've lugged 18 gallons of water from the house to the van. So my 17.6 gallon tank of fresh water is full, but none of it got into the hot water heater yet. And I'm going to show you how to do that. And we're going to have to go into the coach, and you're going to have to go on the driver's side where that seat is on the driver's side of the cushions. You're going to have to lift up the cushions. Then you're going to have to take off the black plastic thing with about 5 screws or so. You got to take that off. And then we're going to look inside and we're going to do a little exploration inside there. We're going to go to the hot water heater. I'm going to show you how to make it so it's bypassed right now. It comes with the factory bypassed. So we're going to unbypass it and we're going to fill it with some nice fresh water.
I've taken off the top, the black piece of plastic that was on top of this. This is the area that's behind the stove and the refrigerator. So let's take a look to see what we have. Well, I can see one thing right now. There's an additional 5 gallons of water storage because the hot water heater has been bypassed. This is what I assume is the water pump right here. It's quite noisy. So let's turn that on for a second. Let me turn on some water. Okay, so the noise it was making, and I've seen this on other videos, this is just all this stuff shaking. Now, the hot water heater. It looks like I can probably put... I need to bleed the air out of here and fill this thing with 5 gallons of water from my tank, and then I'll put 5 more gallons in, so I have a total of 23 gallons. But what's important here is... Let me show you what's going on. This is down the bottom is your cold water. The blue one down here. This is blue. And that's the cold water. It's coming directly out of the pump. Which also, this little extension here obviously is going to the front sink. So this is your cold water to the front sink. This is your cold water coming into the hot water heater. And also, off of here becomes your cold water for the shower and the toilet and all that. But this is bypassed. And what's going on here is this valve here is closed. That valve down there is closed. This valve here is on. So what's happening is, since this is closed, that's closed, nothing is going into this large tank, which is insulated, which is the hot water tank. It's a 5-gallon hot water tank. So what I need to do to use the hot water is I need to close the bypass, number one. Okay, so now the water does not bypass through. I need to open this one, and this one, which just turned on the pump. And that is filling the hot water tank. But I think I probably need to open up the hot water faucet. Gotta get in here, put this down. It should just be air. Okay, so that's the hot water portion. So this should be, here it comes, it should come eventually. Because I have to fill that 5-gallon tank. Again, getting a little bit here. There we go, there we go. I have 17 gallons in my fresh water tank, so I should be able to fill that 5-gallon tank with no problem. So once we do this, then we can check out the hot water and see if it works. I should run outside and make sure it's not leaking on the ground. I should do that. Let me do that real quick. In there. Okay, so nothing's leaking in here. I put this in. This is leaking just a little bit. I'll tighten that later. So let's go back inside. I'm still just getting air here. Let's see what the cold water is doing. Nothing. Let's open up this one. There we go. I think that's it. Here we go. Down here too. Okay. I'm gonna turn this off. This is going pretty good. Now we should have cold water. Yep. Okay. Okay, so the tank should be full. Okay, so that's cold. And that's hot. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to turn off the inverter because I really don't need that. I turn on the hot water heater. So hot water heater reset. Now what does that mean? Oh, it just clicked in. Okay. So the light went off and it came back on. Okay, it just clicked again. You go take a look at the propane. I mean, the propane. Oh, I don't think it is on. I think the propane's off. We're gonna get this. We're gonna get this yet, folks. Oh, it's all wet. Ram's all wet. Let me on this thing. Okay, so that gas is on now. But this says reset. I hear something. It could be the inverter. Push the reset. Push which one? Some gas. This is definitely not going. It's definitely not going. Let's try it one more time. So it comes right to the reset. I don't think it needs the battery. I mean, it doesn't need the inverter. I hear something. Sounds like something's cooking now. The red light is out. So let's go back around, see what's going on. Yeah, I'm still losing water somewhere. Not as bad. It's definitely going now. Oh yeah, let's get heat to it. So, it definitely is making hot water. So we're back in the coach, and we're just waiting to see if we really get hot water. It was warmer. Oh, here we are. I wouldn't call it hot, but it's warmer.
It's been on for like
10
minutes.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for watching. And this is just to get the water tanks going. And I was successful. The only problem I had is if you look on the screen there, you can see water dripping from the hot water heater. And there's a anode. I think it's called anode. Is that what it's called? Anode? Yeah. Anode rod that goes into the bottom of the hot water heater. What that does is attract all the bad stuff that's going to corrode your hot water heater. So it actually saves the hot water heater by attracting iron, ferrous things and whatever. Anyways, I could not get that thing to tighten on tight enough. And I just want to tell you, you need a socket wrench that is a 1 1/16 inch socket wrench will work. And I used these pliers. See those pliers right there? I tightened it down enough, but I could not get that thing tight enough until I got my socket wrench. So just want to share that with you. Okay, and now I'm going to have an upcoming video about the tanks, the other tanks. The gray and black water tanks. There's two separate tanks in the system, and they drain separately. Oh, what fun that's going to be. Okay. Well, thanks. I just let that fat guy work in that RV there and talk to you later. Goodbye.